طيب، بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، today بإذن الله تعالى is continuation from the daily lessons and this مجلس الثاني عشر. So today is the 12th sitting from the sittings of the daily sittings of Ramadan from the book of Sheikh Salih Uthaymeen رحمه الله. So today, inshallah, we're going في النوع الثاني من تلاوة القرآن, from the second type of recitation of the Quran. So this was previously mentioned by Brother Shaib in lesson 5. So we're going to the first type. So this is the second type. So let's begin with the introduction. Bismillah. So he said, the Sheikh mentions here, الحمد لله معطي الجزيل لمن أطاه ورجاه. So all praise belongs to Allah, the one who gives in abundance to the ones who obey him and have hope in him. وشديد العقاب لمن أعرض عن ذكره وعصاه. And he is severe in punishment to those who turn away from him, his remembrance, and disobey him. اجتبى من شاء بفضله فقربه وأدناه. So he chooses who he wills by his grace, and he brings them close to him. وأبعد من شاء بأدله فولاه ما تولى. And he turns and keeps far away, makes far away whoever he wills by way of his justice, and he turns them away. Yeah. So he keeps them far away and he turns them away. أنزل القرآن رحمة للعالمين ومنارا للسالكين فمن تمسك به نال مناه. So here the mentions that Allah revealed the Quran as a mercy to all of the creation, mankind and jinn, and as a beacon or a light for those who tread the path. So whoever holds on to it in the Quran has indeed, you know, will indeed attain his goal. وَمَنْ تَعَدَّ حُدُودُهَا وَأَضَاءَ حُقُوقُهُ خَسِرَ دِينَهُ وَدُنْيَاهُ. And whoever transgresses the limits of the Quran and he wastes it or loses it, its rights upon him, indeed he's lost his religion and he's lost the worldly life. أحمده على ما تفضل به من الإحسان وأعطاه. So I praise him upon all the righteous, you know, all the good that he good and what he has given. So all the good and all that he has given. So then the Sheikh he mentions, وأشكره على نعمه الدينية ودنيوية وما أجدر الشاكر بالمزيد وأولاه. So and I thank him upon all the blessings that are in the deen and in the worldly life, and the one who is grateful, he will have an increase in reward. So the grateful person is indeed worthy of receiving more. Then he mentions, the Sheikh mentions here, وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له, لا شريك له الكامل في صفاته المتعالي عن النظراء والأشبائه. So I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah, and he has no partners. And without a partner, and he has the perfect attributes, and he is high above all rivals. So وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الذي اختاره على البشر واصطفاه، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان، ما انشق الصبح وأشرق ضياه وسلم تسليما. So the Sheikh mentions that I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah. And then he says, I bear witness that Muhammad is his slave and messenger. He chose him and gave him preference over all mankind. May Allah send his salutations and blessings upon his family, his members, and his companion, and those who follow their footsteps along the daylight, as long as the daylight continues to brighten the universe. So then the Sheikh, he goes on and he mentions, إخواني سبق في المجلس الخامس أن تلاوة القرآن على نوعين، تلاوة لفظه وهي قراءته، وتقدم الكلام عليها هناك. So as we mentioned previously, he says, my brothers, in the previous sitting, the fifth sitting, which Brother Shaib did, so you can review that in the Telegram channel, that the recitation of the Quran is of two types. The recitation of the words and the letters, and that is reading the Quran, that's which preceded in the fifth lesson. والنوع الثاني تلاوة حكمه بتصديق أخباره واتباع أحكامه فعلا للمأمورات وتركا للمنهيات. So then the Sheikh mentions, and the second type is recitation of its rulings and believing in the news that has been mentioned and following its complying with and following the rulings and acting, upon the commands, acting upon the commands and leaving what has been prohibited. So then he said, وهذا النوع هو الغاية الكبرى من إنزال القرآن كما قال الله قال تعالى كتاب أنزلناه إليك مباركا ليدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. So the Sheikh here, let's mention this. So the Sheikh, he first says, and this type, where you learn the meaning of the rulings and believe in the news that came in Quran, and you follow the rulings and you adhere to the commands and you stay away from those things that are prohibited. So this type is the great goal from the purpose of the revelation of the Quran as the Most High. He mentions here, let me just get the ayah. So that is Surah Al-Sad, ayah number 29. This is a book, the Quran, which we have sent down to you, full of blessings, that they may ponder over its verses, and that men of understanding may remember. So that is to ponder over it, the Quran, and to as well as the reading. Yeah. As Brother Shaib already mentioned, the benefits and the blessings of reading Quran in this blessed month as well, but also pondering over that. And that's the reason to understand the Quran as well, not just merely reading. وَلِحَذَا دَرَجَ السَّلَفُ الصَّالِحُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَعَلَى ذَلِكَ يَتَعَلَّمُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَيُصَدِّقُونَ بِهِ وَيُطَبِّقُونَ أَحْكَامَهُ تَطْبِيقًا إِيجَابِيًا عَنْ عَقِيدَةٍ رَاسِخَةٍ وَيَقِينٍ صَادِقٍ. So here the Sheikh, he mentions that for this reason the Salaf, they would gradually advance the righteous practices, may Allah be pleased, advance step by step they would learn the Quran, and then they would believe in it, and then they would apply the rulings, a positive application, basically the aqidah, that is firmly rooted, and that they believe in it, in the true and believe that it's true, and have that firm that certainty in what was revealed. So then the Sheikh mentioned, Qala Abu Abdul Rahman al-Sulami rahimahullah, rahimahullah, haddathana alladhina kanu yuqri'unana al-Qur'an, Uthman ibn Affan wa Abdullah ibn Mas'ud wa ghayruhuma, annahum kanu idha ta'allamu min an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 10 ayatin lam yatajawazuha hatta yata'allamuha wama fiha min al-ilm wal-amal. Qalu fata'allamna al-Qur'ana wal-ilma wal-amala jami'an. وهذا نوع من التلاوة هو الذي عليه مدار السعادة والشقاوة. We stop there. So then the Sheikh mentioned that Abu Abdul Rahman al-Sulami, rahmullah, who passed away in the 3rd century, he mentioned, may Allah be pleased him, that you know, those who narrated, you know, those who taught us the Quran from the likes of Uthman bin Affan, yeah, was a companion, and Abdullah bin Mas'ud, also a companion, may Allah be pleased with them, and other than them, that they used to, meaning the Sahaba, they used to learn from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly 10 verses, and they wouldn't, you know, go past beyond those 10 verses until they learned them verses and what was in them from knowledge and action. They used to say, we used to learn the Quran, knowledge and action together. And this is the type of recitation which is the, you know, our happiness revolves around, and our wretchedness. So if someone doesn't pull a lot there, that's wretchedness. While someone who does ponder over these ayahs, then the happiness revolves around that. So here, yeah, I've obviously come across this narration before, but by Ibn Mas'ud himself, he's mentioned here, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, that they wouldn't go past 10 verses, except that they would know the meaning, memorize it, understand it, and implement it. Yeah, which is the actions. So then the Sheikh mentions that قال الله تعالى فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعْ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَذِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً وَتَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قال ربي لما حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تمسى وكذلك نجزي من أسرف ولم يؤمن بآيات ربه والعذاب الآخرة أشد وأبقى. So this is Surah Taha, and it's verse 123 to 127. So inshallah, we'll go over that. So it's a proof of obviously pondering over the Quran, learning and implementing and acting upon the Quran. So going on this ayah now, the first one said, He Allah said, get you down from paradise to the earth, meaning Adam and Hawa, both of you together. Some of you are an enemy to some others, meaning to Shaitan, Iblis. Then if there comes to you guidance from me, then whoever follows my guidance, he shall neither go astray nor shall be distressed. But whoever turns away from my reminder, I neither believes in this Quran nor acts on its teachings, verily for him is a life of hardship. And we shall raise him up blind on the day of resurrection. Subhanallah. Raised up blind. So whoever doesn't turns away from the Quran will be raised up blind. He will say, "Oh my Lord, why have you raised me up blind while I had sight before?" Allah will say, like this, our ayat, proofs, evidence, and verses, and lessons, and revelation came unto you, but you disregarded them. And you left them, you did not think deeply in them, and you turned away from them. And so this day, you will be neglected in the hellfire, away from Allah's mercy. So then he mentions, and thus do we require him who transgresses beyond bounds, commits the great sins, and disobeys his Lord Allah, and believes not in his messengers and his revealed books, like the Quran, and believes not in the ayat, proofs, evidence, and the verses, lessons, and signs, and revelations of his Lord, and the torment of the hereafter is far more severe and more lasting. So, subhanAllah, it shows you, the severe punishment, yeah, for those who don't reflect upon the Quran and turn away from the Quran and leave it to gather dust, So we should ponder over the Quran and read it throughout the year, but even more in this month that it was revealed, and the Prophet ﷺ would go over the Quran with Jibreel, would go over it with the Prophet ﷺ again. So then the Sheikh continues and says, فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ الْكَرِيمَةِ ثواب المتبعين لهداه الذي أحواه إلى رسله وأعظمه هذا القرآن العظيم. So then the Sheikh says, and Allah clarified in these ayahs, in these verses, these noble verses, the reward for those who follow his guidance, for the guidance which Allah has revealed to his messengers. And the greatest of these is the Quran, the great Quran. And Allah وَبَيِّنَ إِقَابَ الْمُؤْرِدِينَ عَنْهُ أَمَّا الثَّوَابَ الْمُتَّبِعِينَ لَهُ فَلَا يَذِلُّونَ وَلَا يَشْقُونَ وَنَفْيُ الضَّلَالِ وَالشَّقَاءِ عَنْهُمْ يتضمن كمال الهداية والسعادة في الدنيا والآخرة وأما إقاب المعرضين عنه المتكبرين عن العمل به فهو الشقاء والضلال في الدنيا والآخرة فإن له معيشة دنكا فهو في الدنيا بأمه وقلق نفس ليس له عقيدة صحيحة وَلَا عَمَلٌ صَالِحٌ. So we stop there and we just translate that. So, and then the Sheikh mentions that Allah also clarified the punishment for those who turn away from the remembrance, from the Quran and the message. So as for those who will be rewarded, the followers, so they will, from that is that they will not be misguided. And there will be of those who are wretched and so that is for those who are the followers. So those who follow, and they will not grieve. Yeah. So the negation of misguidance and being wretched and grieving from them, it contains in there the completeness of guidance and happiness. This life and the hereafter, so you'll be guided. So you could, the opposite is misguidance, so you're protected from misguidance and from grieving and being from wretched in this life and the hereafter. As for the punishment of those who turn away and are arrogant and deny the ayahs, and turn away from the acting upon the Quran, then for them is despair and misguidance in this life and the hereafter, and they have a hard life. They have a hard life for them. Yeah. So here they have a hard life for them. سو معيشة لايف اوف هاردشيب، معيشة ضنكة. And he in this life he will be full of worry and grief in his soul, and he won't have the right aqidah, he won't have a right belief and creed, and he won't have righteous actions. Then Allah mentions ulaika كالأنعام بل هم أضل أولئك هم الغافلون. سورة الأعراف was 179, which basically means that they are like cattle, nay even more astray, those they are the heedless ones. So these are the people who deny the Quran and they don't reflect upon it. So especially the disbelievers. So وهو في قبره في ضيق ودنك قد ضيق عليه قبره حتى تختلف أضلاعه وهو في حشره أعمى لا يبصر ونحشرهم يوم القيامة على وجوههم عميا وبكما وصما مأواهم جهنم كلما خبت زدناهم صعيرا فهم لما عموا في الدنيا عن رؤية الحق وصموا عن سمائه وأمسكوا عن النطق به وقالوا قلوبنا في أكنة مما تدعونا إليه وفي آذاننا وقر ومن بيننا وبينك حجاب فجزاهم الله في الآخرة بمثل ما كانوا عليه في الدنيا وأضاءهم كما أضاءوا شرعيته قال ربي لما خشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى جزاء وفاق ومن جاء بالسيئة فلا يجزى الذين عملوا السيئات إلا ما كانوا يعملون. So that was a paragraph full of Quran ayahs. We're going to go through the proofs. So the Sheikh, he mentions here that the person who rejects the Quran from the disbelievers and those who in his grave, he'll be very narrow, and so his grave will be very narrow for him, and he'll be distressful for him. It'll be a distressful situation for him, and until his ribs they join together because of the pressure that there are from both sides on him. For the punishment that he will be getting in the grave. Allah protect us from that. And and when he will be raised up on the day of judgment, he will be raised blind. He won't be able to see. And then here again, the Quran ayah that they mentioned here, وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ, which is, and we shall gather them together on the day of resurrection, on their faces, blind, dumb, and deaf. Their lobe will be hell. Whenever it abates, we shall increase for them the fierceness of the fire. So that is the ayah Surah Isra, that they be raised blind. And they will, when they are blind, So the Sheikh mentions because they are blind in the world from seeing the truth. So they will be, and they are deaf, from hearing the truth. So and then they carried on, speaking with that, sticking to that, staying away from the guidance, seeing it, the truth, and hearing it. So then it will be said, it'll be said, وَقَلُوبُنَا, and they say, our hearts are under coverings, screened from that to which you invite us, and in our ears is deafness, and between us and you is a screen. So work you on your way, and verily we are working on our way. So that's what the disbelievers used to say. So that's Surah Fusilat. So Allah will punish them in the hereafter because of the likes of what they used to do in the in this life. So Allah will get, you know, make them lose and be forgotten. How the way they you know, forgot the Sharia of Allah, you know, they didn't they neglected it. So then we already read this ayah where they say, will say to Allah, he will say, oh my Lord, why have you raised me up blind while I had sight before? And then he mentioned Allah will say, like this, our ayah, proof and evidences and revelation came unto you, but you discarded them, you left them, you didn't deeply think about them and turned away from them. And so this day you will be neglected in the hellfire, away from Allah's mercy. So it shows that Allah will neglect them, put them in the hellfire. So then he mentions, jaza'un wifaqa. So here, it's you know, a reward. How do you say that? Yeah, an exact recompense according to the evil crimes. So that's Surah Naba. And then Surah Qasas mentions that whoever brings good Islamic monotheism along with righteous deeds, he shall have the better thereof. And whoever brings evil polytheism along with evil deeds, then those who do evil deeds will only be requited for what they used to do. So the evil person, the person who used to do evil, will be rewarded with the evil on the day of judgment. And then the Sheikh, he mentions, he's mentioned a hadith here, Sahih Bukhari. So he mentioned it here. وفي صحيح البخاري عن سمرة بن جندب رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان إذا صلى صلاة وفي لفظ صلاة الغداة أقبل علينا بوجهه فقال من رأى منكم ليلة رؤيا قال فإن رأى أحد قصاها فيقول ما شاء الله فسألنا يوما فقال هل رأى أحد منكم رؤيا قلنا لا قال لكني رأيت الليلة رجلين أتياني فساق الحديث وفيه. So I'm just going to translate that and then we'll continue inshallah. So in Sahih Bukhari, so it's authentic hadith from the companion Sumra bin Jundab, may Allah be pleased with him, that the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if he used to pray, and in another wording, if he used to pray the morning prayer, the Fajr prayer, he would come to us and face us and say, who from you saw a dream, you know, so who saw a dream last night? So if we saw, so if any one of us saw something, then we would narrate that dream, and he would say, you know, whatever Allah wills, mashallah. So on a particular day, he asked us if any of us saw a dream. So we said no. So he said, but I saw a dream at night. Two men came to me. So then he began to narrate the dream. So then we carry on from here. فَإِنْ تَلَقْنَا حَتَّى أَتَيْنَا عَلَىٰ مَدَّجِئِ وَإِذَا آخَرُ قَائِمٌ عَلَيْهِ بِسَخْرَةٍ وَإِذَا هُوَ يَحْوِي بِسَخْرَةٍ لِرَأْسِهِ فَيَثْنَخُ رَأْسَهُ فَيَتَدَحْدَهُ الْحَجْرُ هَا هُنَا فَيَتَّبِعُ الْحَجْرَ فيأخذه فلا يرجع إلى الرجل حتى يصح رأسه كما كان ثم يعود عليه فيفعل به مثل ما فعل به المرأة الأولى. So we just translate this. So then they carried on until the two men came to Prophet ﷺ. They were the angels, and they came, took the Prophet with them until they came upon a man who was laying down on the ground, and another man, he was standing over him with a rock, and he would drop and smash that rock upon his head. And then the rock would, after smashing that person's head with the rock would roll here and there, and the other man who smashed the rock on the laying man's head would follow it, until he got the rock and returned to the man, and until this happened, the man whose head was smashed in, it would have recovered and healed, and how it was before. Then the man who would smash his head, he would do it again like he did the first time. So the Prophet said, "Fakultu." So I said, "Subhanallah, all praise be to Allah. What is this? Ma hadha?" Faqala li. So the two angels said to the Prophet sallam, "Intaliq, carry on." فذكر الحديث وفيه. So he is in a long hadith, and they carried on. So then he returns back to the hadith. أما الرجل الذي أتيت عليه يثلخ رأسه بالحجر فهو الرجل يأخذ القرآن فيرفضه وينام عن الصلاة المكتوبة. سبحان الله. So here the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, as for the man who I came to, and he had a rock being smashed on his head with then he is someone who used to take the Quran, meaning and then he would reject it. So whether that is whether he read the Quran and he wouldn't apply it or wouldn't contemplate on it or would leave it, could be, so the scholars could explain that further, but he would take the Quran but reject it, and he would sleep at the time of the prescribed obligatory prayers. So he would sleep without praying the obligatory prayers. So think about that. Missing out the prayer, and look at the Quran as well. So basically, the one who rejects it, he receives the knowledge of the Quran and rejects it. Subhanallah. So we need to, be careful that we learn the Quran, memorize it, read it, and we apply it. So that is a severe warning for us. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خطب الناس في حجة الوداع فقال إن الشيطان قد يأس أن يعبد في أرضكم ولكن رضي أن يطاع فيما سوى ذلك مما تحاقرون من أعمالكم فاحذروا إني تركت فيكم ما إن تمسكتم به فلن تضلوا أبدا كتاب الله وسنة نبيه رواه الحاكم وقال صحيح الإسناد. So here is another hadith by narrated by Ibn Abbas. So he's a cousin of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. May Allah be pleased with both of them, his uncle and his cousin. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was giving a sermon. On the farewell pilgrimage, the pilgrimage, the Prophet ﷺ passed away after this, and he said the devil has given up hope of him being worshipped in the land of yours, in the Jazirat al Arab, but he's pleased to be obeyed, and other than that, from among your deeds that you belittle. So from the deeds that you belittle, he can, enter through there, make you weak upon acting upon those. So, be warned. Always plot. And then the Prophet said, indeed I left among you, if you grab on, hold on to them. If you cling to them, you will not go astray ever. And that is the Kitab Allah, Quran, the Book of Allah, and the Sunnah of His Messenger, meaning the Sunnah of the Prophet. And Hakim narrated this, and he said that his chain is correct. And Imam Ahmad and a lot of other scholars have narrated this hadith from Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him as well. So from another companion. So then he mentioned another hadith an Amr bin Shu'aib an Abihi an Jaddihi waqala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يمثل القرآن يوم القيامة رجل فيؤتى برجل قد حمله فخالف أمره فيمثل له خصما فيقول يا ربي حملته إياي فبئس الحامل تعدى حدودي وضيق فرائدي وركب معصيتي وترك طاعتي فما يزال يقذف عليه بالحجج حتى يقال شأنك به فيأخذه بيده فما يرسله حتى يكبه على منخره في النار. So here subhanallah he mentioned the hadith from the nation of Amr bin Shu'aib, may Allah be pleased with him, from his father, from his grandfather, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the Quran, it will come in the appearance of the of a man, and then he will come with a man. He will come with a man who used to carry the Quran. Yeah, who memorized it, you know, carried the Quran, but he didn't. But he opposed it. He opposed in his command, in his actions. Yeah, so he opposed it. So he did not implement it. So then he came in the appearance of his opposer. He came in the appearance of his opponent or adversary, and he said, "So the Quran, he will say, oh my Lord, you made him carry me, and what a wretched or bad carrier of the Quran. So what a evil carrier he is. Yeah, that he transgressed my boundaries. Yeah? He transgressed the limits of the Quran, and he neglected my obligations, and he committed ma'siyah, sins, committed prohibitions, yeah, and he left my obedience, yeah, he disobeyed me, and he will continue, you know, with the ever throwing evidences against that man until it will be sent to the Quran, take him and take him and do according to what he deserves. So then he will be dragged, that person will be dragged on his nose, and he will be flung into the hellfire. And Sheikh Uthaymeen, in some narrations, I mentioned it as is a weak hadith, but others, so Da'if Naql and Al Hafid Ibn Hajar, so Ibn Hajar made it know that it's weak. وتحسينه فإن ثبت أنه حسن فالممثل قراء القاري وجزاؤه. So yeah, some of the scholars have said that it's weak. Some have said that it's authentic or hasan, but the meaning behind it is still correct, and it mentions now in a Sahih hadith wa fi Sahih Muslim. So this is a Sahih hadith and Abi Malik Al Ash'ari, from Abu Malik Al Ash'ari, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Qala al Quran hujja lak wa aw alayk." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Is the Quran is a proof for you or against you?" Yeah, so that's true. That's Sahih hadith. So that is either proof for you or against you on the Day of Judgment. We know that will happen. وقال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه, and Ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, القرآن شافع مشفع فمن جعله أمامه قاده إلى الجنة ومن جعله خلف ظهره ساقه إلى النار. So he said, Ibn Mas'ud, he mentioned that the Quran intercedes, like intercession is granted for his sake. So whoever puts the Quran in front of himself, he will lead him to the paradise, Jannah, and whoever places the Quran behind his back, he will lead him to hellfire. And that's basically raised to the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the hadith. And then the Sheikh said, فَيَا مَنْ كَانَ الْقُرْآنَ خَصْمَهُ. So he says, woe to the one who the Quran is his opponent, adversary. كَيْفَ تَرْجُو مِمَّنْ جَعَلْتَهُ خَصْمَكَ شَفَاءً. How do you expect for the one that you made your opponent, your adversary, intercession? وَيْلٌ لِمَنْ شَفَاءُهُ خُصَمَاءُهُ يَوْمَ تَرْبَهُ الْبَدَاءَ. So then the Sheikh, he mentions, he says, woe to be those whose intercessors will become his opponents on the day of benefiting from them. So then the Sheikh, he mentions here, he says, Ibad Allah, O slaves of Allah, هذا كتاب الله يتلى بين أيديكم ويسمع. So this book of Allah is being recited to you, which you can hear. وهو القرآن الذي لو أنزل على جبل لرأيته خاشعا يتصدى. He said that if this Quran, which if it was to be revealed on a mountain, you would have seen the mountains humbling themselves, crumbling to dust. Then he mentions, وما هذا فلا أذن تسمع ولا عين تدمع ولا قلب يخشى ولا امتثال للقرآن فيرجى به أن يشفى قلوب خلت من التقوى فهي خراب بلقى وتراكمت عليه ظلمة الذنوب فهي لا تبصر ولا تسمع كما تتلى علينا آيات القرآن وقلوبنا كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. So we stop there, we translate that and then carry on. So then the Sheikh, he says, even though this is the fact about the Quran, that the ears do not listen, the eyes do not shed tears, and the heart is not affected by it, and the people do not adhere to its teachings in order that it will be the means of intercession, the hearts are void of fear of Allah, and are ruined, and are overshadowed with the darkness of sins, and as a result, they neither see nor hear. So here, then he says, they neither see nor hear the Quran being recited, but yet our hearts are as hard as rocks, and even harder. La ashabu minna. So then he said, وكما يتوالى علينا شهر رمضان وحالنا في كحال أهل الشقوى لا الشاب منا ينتحي عن السبوة ولا الشيخ ينتحي عن القبيح فليحكوا بأهل الصفوة أين نحن من قوم إذا سمعوا داعي الله أجاب الدعوة وإذا تليت عليهم آياته وجلت قلوبهم وجلتها جلوة أولئك قوم أنعم الله عليهم فعرفوا حقه فاختاروا الصفوة. So here then the Sheikh mentions that so they said the youth do not desist from their youthful passion and desires, nor do the elders desist from the evil actions. So before that, even he mentions here, let's go. Yeah, وَكَمْ يَتَوَالَى. So he says, وَكَمْ يَتَوَالَى. So the Sheikh, he mentions, and how many times does Ramadan reach us? Yet our conditions are like the condition of the wretched ones. The youth do not desist from their youthful passions and desires, nor do the elders desist from their evil actions, so and strive to catch up with the pious ones. Where are we from those people who, when they hear the call of Allah, they answer it, and when His revelations are recited to them, they have tranquility in their hearts. They are the ones whom Allah has bestowed His bounties upon. Consequently, they are knew Allah's right, and they chose the best deeds. Yeah. So then the Sheikh mentions, قال ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه. Ibn Mas'ud mentioned, and may Allah be pleased with him, ينبغي لقارئ القرآن أن يعرف بالليله إذا الناس ينامون وبنحاره إذا الناس يفطرون وببقائه إذا الناس يضحكون وبورئه إذا الناس يخلطون وبسمته إذا الناس يخوضون وبخشوعه إذا الناس يختالون وبحزنه إذا الناس يفرحون. So Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased, said the Quran, the one who reads the Quran, the one who reads the Quran, he must be known by his night while the people are sleeping. So meaning, he reads the Quran while the people are sleeping, by his day while the people are eating. So by his crying while the people are laughing, because by remembering the Quran, by his cautiousness while the people are careless, by his silence while the people are chatting, by his humbleness while the people are being proud, and by his sadness while the people are happy. Yeah, and that is because of the pondering of the Quran and knowing the reality of his life. Yeah. So then we got some poetry. Ya nafsu faz as-salihuna bit-tuqa wa absaru al-haqqa wa qalbi qad amiya ya husnan wal-laylu qad ajannahum wa nuruhum yafuqu nur al-anjumi tarannamu bil-dhikri fi laylihim fa'ayshuhum قد طاب بترتم قلوبهم للذكر قد تفرغت ودموعهم كلؤلؤ منتظم أزهارهم بنورهم قد أشرقت وخلع الغفران حير القسم قد حفظوا صيامهم من لغوهم وخشعوا في ليلي في ذكرهم وويحقي يا نفس ألا تيقظي للنقع قبل أن تزل قدمي مدى الزمان في تواني وحوى فاستدرقي ما قد بقي واغتنمي. So here the Sheikh is reading this poem, and the poem basically reads, O soul, the righteous are successful with piety, and they saw the truth while my heart is blinded from it. How beautiful they are when they are covered by the darkness of the night, and you see their glow brighter than the radiance of the stars. They hymn the praise of their Lord in the evenings, in the evenings. Their life is indeed pleasant with the glorification of their Lord. And then he mentions their hearts are occupied with the remembrance of Allah. Their tears are like orange pearls. Their dawn is illuminated with their light. And then he means being forgiven is the best appointment. They have preserved their fasting from absurdity. They humble themselves in the night in their remembrance. Woe to you, O soul, will you not awake towards that will benefit you before the instability of your feet? Many years have passed by in our negligence of undesire. Therefore, catch up with what is left from your age and take advantage. So that is also from that book of Ibn Rajab, Lata'if al-Ma'arif, that Brother Shai mentioned previously. And then the Sheikh mentions, Ikhwani ifadhu al-Quran qabla fawat al-imkan. So the Sheikh mentions, brothers, or my brothers, memorize the Quran before you lose the ability. وحافظوا على حدوده من التفريط والإسيان, and preserve the limits and not transgressing against them and disobeying them. وَأَعْلَمُوا أَنَّهُ شَاهِدٌ لَكُمْ أَوْ عَلَيْكُمْ إِنْدَ الْمَلِكِ الْأَدَّيَّانِ. So he said, know that the Quran will be a witness for you or against you in the front of the king, the judge, Allah. ليس من شكر نعمة الله بإنزاله أن نتخذه وراءنا ذحريا, وليس من تعظيم حرمات الله أن تتخذ أحكامه سخريا. So then the Sheikh, he said, being grateful to Allah for revealing this book means that we should not throw it behind our backs. And honoring Allah's commandments comprises not taking the religion and the religious rulings as a form of mockery. The Sheikh, he mentioned Quran ayah. ويوم يعد الظالم على يديه يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتى ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد اضلني عن الذكر بعد اذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للانس خذولا. وقال الرسول يا ربي إن قومي اتخذوا هذا القرآن محجورا, وكذلك جعلنا لكل نبي عدوا من المجرمين وكفى بربك هاديا ونصيرا. So I'm just going to read these ayahs that are from Surah Furqan, verse 27 to 31. So the first one, he says, I remember the day when the zalim, the wrongdoer, the oppressor, the apologist, will bite at his hands, and he will say, oh, would that I had taken a path with the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ah, woe to me, would that I had never taken so and so as a close intimate friend, Khalil. He indeed led me astray from the reminder of this Quran after it had come to me, and Shaitan, Iblis, is to man ever a deserter in the hour of need. So that was, and then he mentions, and the messenger Muhammad will say, oh my Lord, verily my people deserted this Quran, neither listened to it, nor acted on its laws and teachings. Thus have we made for every prophet an enemy among the disbelievers and polytheist criminals, but sufficient is your Lord as a guide and a helper. So that is what the Sheikh mentioned there. And then the Sheikh, he finishes with a dua. And he says, Allahumma arzuqna tilawata kitabik haqqa tilawati. So he said, oh Allah, allow us to recite your book as it should be recited. Waj'alna mimman nala bihi falaha wa sa'ada. And make us those who obtain the success and happiness with it. Allahumma arzuqna iqamata lafzihi wa ma'nahu. Allah make us, those who establish the words and the meanings of the Quran. إِخَانَ اللَّفْظِ وَمَعْنَاهُ وَحِفْظَ حُدُودِهِ, and to protect its limits. وَرِعَايَةَ حُرْمَاتِهِ, and preserve its limits and not go beyond them. And then he said, اللَّهُمَّ اجْعَلْنَا مِنَ الرَّاسِخِينَ فِي الْعِلْمِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بمحكمه ومتشابهه تصديقا بأخباره وتنفيذا لأحكامه. So then he mentions, oh Allah, make us from amongst those who are firmly grounded in knowledge and those who believe in both the clear and the unclear verses. And then he mentioned أخبار تخفيز and to implement its rulings. واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولوالدينا واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. They said, forgive us and our parents and the rest of the Muslims, Ummah, with your mercy, for verily you are the most merciful. Allah send your salutations upon our Prophet Muhammad and his family and on all of his companions. So with that, we finish. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام